Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today's video is going to be a complete guide on how to play Pain. In this video, I'll be covering all the basic abilities of Pain as well as I'll be giving you some advanced tips on how to play him in the end of the video. So make sure to watch the video till the end. You'll learn a lot of things that you didn't know about Pain. Also, if you're new to the channel, make sure to check out my other videos as well. And if you like the content, make sure to subscribe to the channel. We are trying to hit 1000 subscribers before the end of this year, and thank you so much for your support. Now with no further ado, let's get right into the video. Pain does not have mana, but instead of mana, he has energy. So his abilities consume energy every time he uses them. At the start of the game, he has a maximum energy of 100, and every time he gets a kill or assist, his energy limit increases by 10 to a maximum of 200. So here, as you can see, his first ability consumes 40 energy, and his second ability also consumes 40 energy, and his third ability, I believe, also consumes the same amount of energy. So in the early game, you will not be able to use 3 abilities at once because they cost 40 plus 40 plus 40, that is 120 energy. But once you start getting some kills or assist, your energy limit will increase and then you will be able to use more abilities because you will have a lot more energy than in the early game. So Pain has ranged auto attacks, but when he uses an ability, his auto attacks deal more damage and turn to melee form. So as you can see here, if I'm using my auto attacks normally, it's ranged auto attacks, but then after I use my ability, his baton starts glowing and his normal attacks will become melee and will deal more damage. Also, the very first normal attack after he uses an ability teleports him behind an enemy and he will attack, dealing 1.75 times the damage of his normal attacks, and he'll be dealing damage to all the enemies in the path. So it is this ability of Pain that makes him a one-shot one-kill hero from the mid-game till the late-game. So this ability is one of the most unique abilities of Pain. He stands and gains iron body, and then he sends a fast-moving spirit that deals magic damage to the enemies it touches as it goes, and it is untargetable. And in the end, Pain teleports to that spirit, and while coming, he also deals damage to all the enemies he touches. So I will show you a demonstration now of what I am talking about. Watch carefully. Now I'll use my first ability and go through Pain, and it will deal some magic damage to him. See, I dealt 120, and when Pain teleports back to that spirit, he also dealt some magic damage again. So see, again, I used my first ability and came through Pain and did some magic damage, and when I teleported back, I did even more magic damage to him. So since this ability gives you untargetability, you can simply go through towers, and if you are able to come out of the tower before the cooldown of your first ability comes up, you will be able to take no damage at all. So this ability will be your main ability to dive under towers and kill their squishies. Also, the body of Pain becomes immune to all crowd control when he is in the spirit form. So except Baldum, Alistair and Arum, no one will be able to use any crowd control on Pain when he is commanding the spirit. Pain silences all the enemies within his range for 0.75 seconds, and if he stays in that circle for 2 seconds, he will also restore 40 energy. So this ability is the only crowd control that Pain has, and it is quite powerful because it silences them, and what silencing does is that it renders the enemies unable to use any of their abilities, and this is crucial because you will be able to escape in that duration. So as you can see here, when I use my second ability, it says silent above the HP bar of Pain. And also, this ability has a passive which I didn't know about before recording this video, and that is, if Pain takes magic damage, he will turn 30% of the damage into his HP for the next 5 seconds. Pain charges for a brief moment and then dashes towards the target location, dealing damage to all the enemies in the path and also dealing 2 times the damage to the enemies whom he lands on. And just like all of his abilities, his next normal attack also gets enhanced. So since this ability has a lot of range, you will be able to surprise your enemies using it, but you have to be very careful. I would not recommend you to use this ability to initiate a fight if you are in solo queue, because if and only if your tank or your support is providing you some crowd control, you will be able to land this ability on an enemy. Otherwise, they will just run away. I'll show you how it looks to the enemy. So as you can see here, when I use my third ability, there is an indicator on the ground which shows where I'll be coming, so all the enemies can just run away from there. So like I told you guys before, Pain also deals damage to all the enemies who are standing in his path when he is dashing, but he deals only half of the damage to them. I'll show it to you now. So let's just fly over Thane and see how much damage we deal to him. So it was around 860 damage, and now let's land on him. See, we deal 860 two times. So as Pain, if you are at low HP and you're recalling back to the altar, you don't need to wait until you get full HP. You can just use your first ability and leave your body there and then just keep going, and your body will automatically heal before it teleports to you. One more important thing that you should know with Pain is that if you are using your first ability to go through the jungle, you will eventually run out of energy, and when you are going to fight, you will not be able to use your abilities. So as you can see, I'm just using my first ability to roam around the map and it is consuming a lot of energy. But what you can do to avoid that is use your second ability, create that circle, and then use your first ability to leave your body alone inside that circle and just keep going. So if your body alone stays there in the circle for 2 seconds, it will automatically give you the energy back. So see, if I'm rotating like that, I'm not losing any energy at all. So any type of heal shield will work only on Pain's body, and it will not work on that spirit. So if you are the support and Pain is at very low HP and he is coming towards you, and if you use your heal on that spirit, he will not gain any HP at all. You have to use the heal when his body is in your range. So this is the basic combo of Pain, but it will be very hard to pull off in a normal match because the enemies will start running away as soon as you use your ult on them. But if they are under crowd control, you can still manage to pull it off. And see, in this combo you will automatically be staying in that circle for 2 seconds. So once you are done with it, you will get 40 energy back, so you will be able to use your first ability to continue fighting, or you can just run away. So this is the combo that I would recommend you guys to use. Go in with your first ability, use a normal attack, and then use your second ability, another normal attack, and then use your ult to get away. So this combo is a lot safer than the first one because you have your ult to get away, whereas in the first one you use all your abilities to jump in, and in the late game, if the enemies are together, you will be able to get one kill and then you will also die. So it's like suicide. So you can use this combo all the time, and especially if you are in solo queue and you don't have anyone to help you engage with, just go in with your first ability, use auto attack, second ability auto attack, then ult away. But while doing this, you have to be very careful if there are heroes like Valheim. So for example, if Krixi and Valheim are standing together, you have to attack Valheim first, because Valheim has his second ability that can stun you, and it's just auto lock. So he can just tap the second ability and you will be stunned. So if you go in and attack Krixi, Valheim will just use his second ability, and when you are trying to fly away, you will get stunned, and then you will stand there and you will have no more abilities to kill Valheim. So he can just kill you. So you have to select your target, and if it's a target with more crowd control, you have to pick them first. So go in, kill them first, and then come out, and then wait for your ult to come back. Your ult has like 15 second cooldown in the late game, so just wait another 15 seconds and then go in again and kill their mage also. So you have to be very careful of heroes like Rass, who can just tap their abilities immediately when you come to attack them. So there is one more very important thing that I noticed while I was playing with Pain, is that if you start snowballing with Pain, that is if you get like 15-20 kills, the opponents will immediately start building magic defense. I've seen it in a match, not just one match, I've seen it in a lot of matches. I'll be Pain and I'll be having like 10 or 15 kills, and what the opponents do is even their marksman will be building Medallion of Troy, and that is magic defense. So this combo will not work on them, and if that situation comes, you need your team to help you win the match. You cannot carry the match alone, because you will not be able to kill even their marksman alone, because they'll be having Medallion of Troy. So even if you build Staff of Null to counter the Medallion of Troy, they will still not die to the two-shot combo. So you need a lot more, but if you stand there, you will die. So it is a really bad situation to be in with Pain, And in that situation, only your team can help you and you will not be able to carry the game solo. I have one more tip for you guys and I'll show it to you in slow motion. Watch what happens. I go in and I attack Hayate and see he's at one bar left and I just use my ult to run away, but the dash from my ult, it also deals damage, right? And that's why he died. So even if the enemies are at 1 HP or 1 bar left, you can just use your ult and make sure that your ult touches them when you dash away, so you will be able to deal that damage and finish them off successfully. So that's gonna be it for today's video guys. I hope you all found this video informative and helpful. And if you did, make sure to support me by hitting the subscribe button. We are trying to hit 1000 subscribers by the end of this year and I thank you all so much for your support till now. So I hope you all have a very great day and I'll see you guys in the next video.